Good evening.
Please keep in mind that Northern Kentucky University is a smoke-free campus. Tobacco products, including the use of e-cigarettes, is prohibited at all locations in the arena and concourse areas. Additionally, please make sure all cell phones and other devices are turned off or set to silent at this time. Family, friends, and guests, we kindly ask that you meet the graduates outside the main lobby and vault entrances. There is no re-entry into the facility. Upon exiting, please be mindful of the elderly and guests in wheelchairs within the concourse area. BB&T Arena staff will be assisting in the concourse to ensure a clear and safe path for all guests to exit the facility. Your cooperation is appreciated. When the commencement and awarding of diplomas begins, I ask for your cooperation by not cheering excessively or using noisemakers, as this makes it difficult for the next graduate and their family to hear their name being called. Thank you in advance for your cooperation with these requests.
Hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad.
Places, the things that I did. You were very broken.
On behalf of the administration, faculty, and staff of Simon Kenton High School, it is my great pleasure to welcome you to the commencement services for the class of 2021. I would like to extend a huge thank you to our school secretaries, Ms. Wan, Ms. Lawson, Ms. Armstrong, Ms. Cooper, and Ms. Munson, for their help in organizing this special event. This event would not be possible without their hard work and dedication. On behalf of the students and staff, we would like to offer a special welcome to the following district administrators: Superintendent of Kenton County Schools, Dr. Henry Webb, Chief Academic Officer, Ms. Shauna Harney, and Assistant Superintendent, Martha Setters. Additionally, we would like to welcome Kenton County Board of Education member, Ms. Karen Collins. Thank you to the parents for your support of your son or daughter to help them reach this milestone. We are very proud of all our students and their accomplishments, and we wish each student success as they transition into adulthood. We would like to extend a special and heartfelt welcome to current and former members of our military and to students joining the military. If you're able to do so, please stand and be recognized at this time. At this time, I would like to ask everyone to please stand, if you're able to do so, for the singing of our national anthem by Simon Kenton students Ella Clark and Annabelle Price.
Stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
At this time, please welcome Taylor Cummins to the stage for her senior address.
Thank you, Ms. Hickey, and thank you to the students and faculty for giving me the opportunity to speak here today. I would like to begin by saying congratulations to everyone here. We adapted, adjusted, and helped each other through, wait for it, unprecedented times. Now, I think we've all heard that word enough. Everyone here has had their own experience, so everyone here should have their own way to describe it. Or maybe for now, let's just go with crazy. In the midst of these crazy times, my family and I started hiking. Did you know how many hiking trails are around here? Neither did we. After half a dozen trips to Ohio, we learned. It was on one of these trails that I started thinking about our shared situation. Most of us feel we have a certain standard to live up to. We believe we must accomplish certain goals to be considered successful in life. But each and every one of us are on our own hiking trails. We are all on our own paths. We will all go through different things and end up in different spots. The more I started to think about life in the trails, the more a connection I saw. Trails are filled with dangers. There are rocks, steep cliffs, roots that catch our feet when we're least expecting it, poison ivy, and worst of all, bugs. But there is also beauty. And I'm not just talking about the end when we finally get to our destinations. I'm talking about the journey there. When we're in the woods and the sun comes through the leaves. When we hear rustling and know there's an animal nearby. When we venture off the path and find a piece of nature seemingly untouched. These are the moments that make the bugs and other dangers worth it. This is a lot like life. We are all on a path. We can't expect that path to be flat and clear of dangers. There will be hard times, really hard times, but we cannot forget the beauty. The beauty in life is not where we end up or how successful we are. The beauty in life is the journey, the small stuff. Consider, though, that trails also have trailheads. Trailheads are maps, a length of the hike, what will be seen along the way. This is something that life and trails do not have in common. In life, we have no idea how long it will be until we reach what we're aiming for. No idea the right direction. No idea what may happen along the way. But that can be a good thing. Unpredictability is beautiful. To quote Eric Roth, I hope you see things that startle you. I hope you feel things you've never felt before. I hope you meet people with a different point of view. I hope you live a life you're proud of. If you're not, I hope you find the strength to start all over again. If you take anything from my speech today, I hope it is that you should always cherish the little moments and never get discouraged by the bugs and other dangers that life throws at you. Thank you. And now Ms. Georgina Campbell will come explain the diplomas and honors.
Good evening. In addition to issuing standard diplomas to graduating seniors this evening, we also want to take a moment to recognize those students who, through extra work and effort, qualify for our summa cum laude diploma, our magnum cum laude diploma, and our cum laude diploma, as well as our honors diploma. Each award comes from hard work, dedication, and a willingness to go above and beyond. Summa cum laude graduates with the highest honors wearing gold stoles this evening. This year, we have 25 students who have earned the summa cum laude honors. The magnum cum laude graduates with great honors wearing silver stoles. This year, we have 69 students who have earned the magnum cum laude honors. The cum laude graduates with high honors wearing bronze stoles. This year, we have 59 students who have earned the cum laude honors. The honors diploma provides students with a sequence of courses and requirements to prepare them for be highly successful in college and includes advanced placement and/or honors classes. This year, we have 67 recipients of the honors diploma. For all 416 students receiving diplomas, the faculty and staff of Simon Kenton applaud your accomplishments. Each accomplishment will be mentioned as students receive their diplomas. For the last time, grads, Ms. Campbell wishes you a good evening, which is really a good morning, Simon Kenton. Make it a great life. The choice is yours. Now, Mr. Craig Reinhardt will present the class of 2021.
Thank you, Ms. Campbell. Hello, faculty, staff, guests, parents, and especially the students of the class of 2021. Dr. Webb, Ms. Collins, and other distinguished guests, I am honored to present the Simon Kenton class of 2021. These students have met all of the graduation requirements of the state of Kentucky and the Simon Kenton High School Site-Based Council. I reflected long and hard about what I would say here today. In my first graduation as principal of Simon Kenton, the only thing that kept coming to mind was, Did that just happen? The next thing that came to mind for me was, we did something pretty impressive this year. We navigated NTI, hybrid, COVID testing, synchronous, in-person, virtual learning, and just about every combination of those throughout the year. No one person or group made this year work. It took all of us here today and countless others pulling in the same direction, so I have to start by thanking some people who made this year successful. To our Central Office and Board of Education leadership, Ms. Collins and her fellow board members, Dr. Webb, Ms. Harney, Ms. Setters, and everyone else who had a role in getting those students back in the building as soon as possible, and also for setting up a system of remote learning, thank you for making that happen. To my leadership team, my faculty, and my staff, I cannot express the gratitude I have because of your flexibility, determination, and focus on helping our students. To our parents, thank you for the sacrifices you have made this year. I know many of you were filling some teacher roles while trying to navigate your own work-from-home experience. To the teachers and the school staff that have worked with these students since preschool, thank you for getting them to us in good shape to keep progressing. I would also be remiss if I didn't thank my predecessor, John Popham, who's here with us today. His guidance has been important to me, and he left things in pretty good shape for me to take over. And also, in case my wife watches this, I need to thank her as well. She put up with a lot of times where I had to work to get things done for school, and she took care of getting my kids to things and making a lot of sacrifices, as many of you in this room have done as well. Finally, thank you to all of you, my students, especially the class of 2021 that is sitting here before me right now. I also do want to take a second to recognize the class of 2020, since their graduation looked nothing like what we are experiencing right now. Their ceremony consisted of a drive-through photograph, which was even pushing the limits of what was permissible at that time. I am happy that many 2020 graduates are working full-time in good jobs, going to colleges, going to trade schools, or are currently serving in the military. They did not let COVID stop them from living their lives, and I want them to know that even though there was not a ceremony like this, their accomplishments have not been forgotten. I'm hoping to get them through the next part okay, but we also said farewell to Mr. Gerard this year. He was one of the best teachers I knew, he was one of my best friends, and he was the best husband and father that anyone could be. I miss him every day, and this school misses him every day. He would be proud of what you all have accomplished. Even this tragic event showed the best of our school community, though. Thousands of dollars were raised by the National Honor Society in his memory, and his legacy lives on through the awarding of scholarships to a worthy senior, including this year's inaugural scholarship going to Delaney McNeese. That brings me to this year's class and their amazing performance. Even with the challenges this class has faced, they have been offered approximately $14 million in scholarships and grants. We have several students who have made the decision to enlist in the military, including sending a student to become a West Point cadet for the second year in a row. We have another state champion wrestler sitting here with us today. We have national merit finalists, essay contest winners, award-winning artists, regional soccer champions, district volleyball champions, the all-time leading scorer in Simon Kenton basketball history, regional archery champions, and members of the Bridge Club who maintain friendships among students of all ability levels, and many other accomplishments that are too numerous to list here. More than that, the members of this class have accomplished something that previous graduates have never done before. All of you sitting here today, whether you maintained straight A's all year long or finished your work yesterday in order to graduate, has successfully completed high school in the middle of a pandemic that has seen society grind to a halt, slowly open, and just now begin to return to some sense of order. Even today, I'm speaking to half of you now, and I spoke to the other half of your class this afternoon in another ceremony, while many of the guests who would otherwise be here watching in person are watching online. It is my belief that you are all stronger for having this experience, and you will look back one day and think, I got through that so I can get through anything. Here's what I'll remember about this class. You were my first of hopefully many classes as principal of Simon Kenton High School. That will remain something special that only this group can be. You used more technology in 1 year than any previous graduating class in their entire academic career. You learned new platforms on the fly and worked efficiently. That will serve you well in whatever you decide to do in life because you have been made adaptable. You all put in work to keep our graduation rate extremely high when every excuse in the world was readily available to quit, but you have persevered. I think the attitude you have displayed throughout this experience fits perfectly well with my favorite quote from Martin Luther King Jr. I have it displayed in my office, and it reads, "If you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward." Would the first two rows of graduates please rise? Ms. Kim Gerard will read the first list of names. You can go ahead.
Jared Donald Borders, summa cum laude, honors diploma. Taylor Lynn Cummins, summa cum laude, honors diploma. Joshua Alexander Donahue, summa cum laude, honors diploma. Brandon Daniel Edwards, summa cum laude, honors diploma. Benjamin Craig Hamilton, summa cum laude, honors diploma. Ian James Hughes, summa cum laude, honors diploma. Avery Elizabeth Jordan, summa cum laude, honors diploma. Abigail Elizabeth Lockman, summa cum laude, honors diploma. Shaylin Jean Mead, summa cum laude. Maddie May Menker, summa cum laude, honors diploma. Aubrey Kathleen Nipper, summa cum laude. Meredith Gwen Perkins, summa cum laude, honors diploma. Paige Marie Robbins, summa cum laude. Caroline Elliott Vaughn, summa cum laude, honors diploma. Abigail Elizabeth Waddell, summa cum laude. Nathan Rayleigh Wells, summa cum laude. Sarah Mackenzie Welp, summa cum laude, honors diploma. London Nicole Acuff, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Grace Isabella Bergman, magna cum laude. Emily Ann Brand, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Whitney Paige Cahill, magna cum laude. Xingwen Lea Chan, magna cum laude. Kylie Faye Claypool, magna cum laude. Brennan Samuel Conrad, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Cade Michael Cunningham, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Aubrey Samantha Dance, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Samantha Danielle Julia Davis, magna cum laude. Tori Catherine Day, magna cum laude. Wyatt Ethan Engelhart, magna cum laude. Darian Ray Etchison, magna cum laude. Daniel Allen Arthur Fagan, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Logan Joseph Finke, magna cum laude. Mariz Ahmad Gerges, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Jalen Nicholas Hammond, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Tyler Chase Hawk, magna cum laude. Austin Lee Henderson, magna cum laude. Brianna Paige Hubert, magna cum laude. Daniel Paul Hutchison, magna cum laude. Callie Tegan Kennedy, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Kennedy Elizabeth Kitchen, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Isabel Grace Claire, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Macy Elizabeth Croman, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Sarah Rose Lawrence, magna cum laude. Carly Madison Little, magna cum laude. Randolyn Marie Little, magna cum laude. Shanti Elise Marshall, magna cum laude. Delaney Marie McNeese, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Landon Charles Meyer, magna cum laude. Catherine Nicole Knockhazel, magna cum laude. Grace Elizabeth Newhouse, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Benjamin Edward Knoll, magna cum laude. Cole Nathaniel Perdue, magna cum laude. cum laude. Jacob Ainer Richmond, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Olivia Nicole Sanchez, magna cum laude. Katie Isabella Shawi, magna cum laude, honors diploma. Nicholas Gerald Seeger, magna cum laude. Jace Lance Sheehan, magna cum laude. Farah Mahmoud Smadi, magna cum laude. Mitchell John Spilly, magna cum laude. Owen Thomas Stevens, magna cum laude. Ashley Nicole Taylor, magna cum laude. Jeremy Cole Adams, cum laude. Trent Thomas Adkins, cum laude. Quinton Edward Bainey, cum laude. Abigail Faith Bitter, cum laude. Jaden Riley Carson, cum laude. Jonathan Michael Chadwell, cum laude. Liam Wallace Champion, cum laude, honors diploma. Chase M. Kaufman, cum laude. Will Harrison Cuthbert, cum laude. Jordan McCall Deshaun, cum laude. Willow Page Downs, cum laude. Taylor Marie Easybuck, cum laude, honors diploma. Justin Michael Eversoll, cum laude. Zoe Renee Fries, cum laude. Ryan Anson Greenwood, cum laude. Jasmine Nicole Heger, cum laude, honors diploma. Alyssa Michelle Gunning, cum laude. Ethan Edgar Hodge, cum laude. Allison Grace Huff, cum laude. Kaya Elise Lampkin, cum laude. Sydney Faye Mansfield, cum laude. Zoe Elizabeth Mansfield, cum laude. Josh Joshua Patrick McKinley, cum laude. Brooklyn Olivia Miller, cum laude, honors diploma. Isabel Ray Miller, cum laude. Ella Catherine Murray, cum laude. Caroline Grace Nightardy, cum laude, honors diploma. Jasmine Marie Null, cum laude. Jacob Sean Nunnally, cum laude. Josephine Renee Phipps, cum laude. Madison Rose Schaub, cum laude. Erin Nicole Sizemore, cum laude. Haley Rose Vallandigham, cum laude. Henry Carter Voorhees, cum laude. Miss Heather Maston will read the next list of names.
Victoria Dawn Abbott. Corey Jason Allen. Cameron Christopher Anderson. Ashley Elizabeth Bennett. Jessica Nicole Bernard. Ariana Paige Bishop. Hunter Emmanuel Black. Austin Gregory Bodie. Natalia Joy Borden. Haley Paige Bowick. Mackenzie Gwyneth Paige Brewer. Dakota Gage Brooksbank. Joseph David Brown. Luke Andrew Carey. Austin Edward Carlisle. Brennan Isaiah Carnes. Julius Joseph Leroy Chandler. Michael James Clarkston. Andrew Joseph Clifford. Kimberly Ann Collette. Teresa Monami Cooper. Atticus Grafton Corwin. Rachel Louise Crouch. Tiffany Ann Jasmine Dan. Kendall Lee Davis. Michaela Lynn Deaton. Aaron Michael Dunaway. Cole Andrew Dunn. Dakota Lee Eggleston. Damaris Anahi Falcon. Gabriel Michael Fitzgerald. Ms. Christine Horline will read the next list of names.
Caleb Dylan Galbraith. Jack Augustus Garner. Tyler Scott Gibson. Justin Ryan Goines. Braden Lee Joseph Haggard. Emily Jean Hall. Alyssa Nicole Harney. Jonah Benjamin Harris, Honors Diploma. Caleb Wayne Hayes. Wilfredo Hernandez, Jr. Carly Michelle Hicks. Kelsey Elizabeth Ray Hodke. Mitchell Robert Husing. Mackenzie Lynn Hunley. Jocelyn Brinkley Hutchinson. Tracy Lee May Isles. Eric Wayne Johnson. Connor Andrew Jones. Andrew Bailey Kelly. Conlon J. Kidwell. Julia Noelle King. Abigail Jolene Claire. Acacia Rhythm Jezebel Cohn. Dakota Tyler Laws. Charles Anthony Lee. Michael Paul Little. Caleb Michael Livers. Dylan Wyatt Long. Destiny Marie Martin. Dariana Lachey Mays. Norm Fernando Mayfield. Brennan Joseph Miller. Dylan Ray Muff. Andrew Christopher Mullen. Ava Julian Neidenbrock. Henry Fong Nguyen. Kelly Christopher Neese. Ms. Leanne Lewis will read the next list of names.
Tyler Christian Plegman. Elizabeth Poe. Samantha Faith Prather. Cody Grant Price. Giselle Yanita Ramirez. Ascencio Raymond Rangel. Aiden Russell Reed. Vincent Charles Rigg. Jacob D. Rowland. Xander Nicholas Rudolph. Noah Christopher Rupert. Eric Jacob Sanders. Justin Matthew Schraber. Justin Fuller Sharp. Cassidy Ann Sharp. Jenna Mai Shipwash. Evan Michael Sims. Cody Scott Sims. Zoe Christine Smith. Darius Tamal Spellman II. Haley Starcher. Jared Russell Stevens. Brandon James Sterling. Emma K. Stratman. Ryan Michael Stretch. Malia Lynn Sullivan. Nicholas Anthony Teton. Dylan James David Thomas. Kevin Jacob Thompson. Cortland Neil Trichler. Brooklyn Lee Villanueva. Caleb Glenn Ward. Dakota Jackson Waymeyer. Cody Michael Weaver. Jeffrey Hunter Williams. Mackenzie Elizabeth Womble. Julius Matthew Woodard. Braxton Jacob Woolham. Maya Cassandra Young.
Time, I'd like to invite Ms. Meredith Perkins up to the stage for her senior address.
Everyone. 250 years ago, I swear the story has a point, so just bear with me. A 16-year-old farmer who thought he had accidentally committed a terrible crime decided to fake his death, change his name, venture alone into the wilderness, join the American Revolution, and establish many Kentucky settlements. Years later, he would realize, surprisingly, he actually hadn't committed a crime, and his departure from society was probably unnecessary. But nonetheless, that man died a legend among Kentucky's frontiersmen. And today, we graduate from his namesake school, Simon Kenton High School. Somewhere there's a lesson to be learned from Simon Kenton's interesting life story. At the very least, his story teaches us, number one, always double-check things, and number two, if plan A doesn't work out, you could always, like, fake your death and become a wilderness explorer. But jokes aside, I bring up Simon Kenton because he has been a part of our identity over the past 4 years. We've worn his name on t-shirts, written it on college applications, cheered it at sporting events, and now, class of 2021, we are Simon Kenton alumni. 4 years ago, it seemed like graduation was, well, 4 years away, but now it's here, finally. However, before we say goodbye to our high school years, I would like to take a quick moment and reflect on the time that our class spent together. When we first entered the halls of SK, none of us knew which classrooms were in the business wing, which school Wi-Fi network was the correct one to use, why the cafeteria was always freezing cold, or why Mr. Bromert's math classroom was always burning hot. Now, 4 years later, we still do not know the answer to these mysteries. While our high school experience was admittedly unconventional, we still enjoyed many time-honored SK traditions. Prom, homecoming, powder puff, chicken tender Wednesdays, teacher versus student dodgeball, a personal favorite of mine. The list goes on. The time we spent at Simon Kenton helped make us the people we are today. Our favorite classes inspired us toward our future career paths. Our least favorite classes taught us to be master procrastinators. And the friends we made along the way showed us how high school can be fun sometimes if you're close to the right people. Of course, these experiences would not have been possible without those who supported us. To the parents in the audience, hi mom, who gave us rides to every sports practice and, when the time came, summoned the courage to let us take the driver's seat, thank you. Thank you for the sacrifices you've made and the encouragement you've given us. To the grandparents, aunts, uncles, and other loved ones here today and virtually, thank you for all of the support and memories over the years. And, of course, to the siblings in the audience, thank you for always reminding us that we are not as cool as we think we are, and thank you for sitting through an entire high school graduation ceremony. I've been in your shoes. My fellow Simon Kenton graduates, in my final words to you, I wish you all the courage to become the person you've dreamed of becoming. Try that college major, create that project, travel to that country, and hey, if life takes you down a really unconventional path, I mean, who knows? You might just get a high school named after you. Thank you, and good luck.
Class of 2021, please rise. Parents and guests, please look at the group that is standing here before you. 17 or 18 years ago, you were looking down at a little baby boy or girl and wondering what the years would hold in store. You were suffering sleepless nights and hoping your child would be successful. I want you to look at this whole class, but especially your child, and realize that baby you held years ago has grown to be a young adult that you can be proud of. Before you all right now stand the next group of leaders in our society, and I can tell you that based on my experience with your kids over the past 4 years, we are all in good hands. Graduates, please know that even though you are no longer a student at Simon Kenton, you will always have a home with us. Please keep in touch and let us know all of your amazing accomplishments. Go from this place today and work to make the world better every day. Graduates, you may now move your tassel to signify transition from your time as a student of Simon Kenton to an alumnus of Simon Kenton. All right, go pick them up.